morning. Good morning.
Right now, I just wanna say thank you. I wanna say, I just wanna say.
Good morning.
Thank you. 'Cause you've been good.
Good morning.
And I wanna say,
good morning.
You've been kind.
Hold on, I forgot something. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Loving me, and I gotta say.
Good morning. Good morning. I'm trying to cook this thing. Good morning, everybody. This is Carla R, also known as the Trailblazer. Welcome to Conversations for Boss Women. As you know, we are going through a 31-day book from Boss Women Pray by Cashel Kelly. The 2 days that we did miss, I am going to upload them on YouTube. I'm going to record them this morning and upload them on YouTube so we do not skip a beat. So we're on day 16, supposed to be on day 18. So I'm going to put 17 and 18 on YouTube and you'll be able to go back and watch it. So thank you so much for inviting your followers and for sharing this on Twitter and Facebook. So today we're going to be talking about prayer for increase in clients, favor, and opportunity. Before we do that, we want to pray. Father, we thank you this morning for an opportunity to come before you in your presence. We acknowledge you, God, and we acknowledge your presence, and we're so grateful for who you are. We're so grateful for another opportunity to be yet in your presence. God, we give you all the glory, honor, and praise. We lean not on our own understanding, but in all our ways, we acknowledge you. And Father, we ask you to cover us, watch over us, protect us, and give us wisdom in the name of Jesus to activate the wisdom that's on the inside of us and teach us how to be boss women, to be who you've called us to be unapologetically and both authentically. And we thank you now in Jesus' name. Amen. Before we get into the book, Boss Women Pray, today's message, I want to share with you about signs. I want to talk about signs that you are on the road to burnout or signs that you are burnt out. Let's deal with that. Oftentimes, there's so much pressure on women that we can have it all, we can do it all, we can be it all. And I want to encourage you, stay in your lane and pay attention to your body. I am someone, I know what it feels like to burn out, and many of you have as well. But one of the things that we have to do is we have to pace ourselves. I'm one of those people, I'm a workaholic. If I get a lot on my mind, I'll throw myself in my work. I don't mind being transparent because the only way that we can help other people is if we are willing to expose ourselves. So I'm someone that what do y'all do? When you get a lot on your mind, when you feel stressed, what is it that you do? When you feel pressure or you get upset or you get mad, some people go shopping. Some people, what do you guys do? You know, put that on the screen. What do you turn to? And let's not be all super deep because you don't always turn to prayer. You don't always turn to your Bible, the word. We're supposed to, but we don't always do that. That's me too. I'll start cleaning. I mean, I'll clean the whole house. And anybody knows me, I'm a neat freak. So my house be already clean. Shopping. Some people shop. Somebody said eat. Turn on music. That's good. Depending on what kind of music. Cut everybody out. Go walking. That's good. So here's the deal. For me, when I get stressed, I just throw myself into my work because my work doesn't feel like work. So and I love what I do. So, I mean, I'll create a program. I'll do this. I'll do that. But then there comes a time when you're, all right, girl, there comes a time, or Spanish girl, because she says she feels like a Spanish girl trapped in a black girl's body. We're going to pray for Kim. But I want to encourage you guys to pay attention to your body and pace yourself. I had a situation yesterday where I just had to shut everything down. Thank you. I contacted my assistant. I said, listen, can't reschedule everything for today. I said, everything. I immediately called the spa and was like, listen, do y'all have anything today? And they was like, yes. I said, praise Jesus. Because I tried to call them on Monday and couldn't get nobody because they're closed on Mondays. And so got in there and just really took time for myself. I mean, I just overdid it. I went and got the 60-minute sweetest massage. I got the facial, the 60-minute facial. Then I went a step further, went and got my nails and my feet done. And I went and ate what I wanted to eat, Tina Moore Brown. No, I did not eat a salad. I ate a Philly cheesesteak and some french fries and I drank water. Why is it that we can eat all this junk? And we'd be like, well, I'm going to drink water or I'm going to get a Diet Coke. No, if I'm going to get a Coke, I'm going to get a Coke. If I'm going to get a Pepsi, I'm going to get a Pepsi. I'm not drinking no Diet Mountain Dew. If I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it all the way. And so I did that unapologetically. But guess what? What did I do wrong? What happened? I didn't pay attention to my body. I have been going nonstop. So first of all, prior to my conference, planning the event, you know what I'm saying? 2 deaths in my family just in November. Y'all, it's only, what, November the 15th? 16th, what's the day? What the day is? Like, 2 deaths in my family, you know. On top of that, my daughter's aunt just passed on Saturday. Planned a conference in the process of already planning. It's the 16th. See what I'm talking about? In the process of planning for another conference, planning, preparing for a tour. But guess what? I had to go back to practicing what I teach. As boss women, it is so easy to get caught up telling everybody what they should do, and thus said the Lord. But how often do we apply that information to ourselves? How often do we apply that? I mean, I woke up with a burden, and the burden that I woke up with, I mean, I was just crying, and I contacted Sarah, and I said, God is showing me celebrities that have to put up this facade. And when I say celebrities, I'm just talking about famous people that everybody feel like have it all together. And one of the people, two of the people I thought about immediately was Whitney Houston and Robin Williams, because sometimes we forget, but celebrities are real people. And I just was crying uncontrollably, just woke up with this burden. Now, how many of you guys know that when you ask God to reveal his burden or to place his burden on your heart, you'll begin to feel what people feel. You'll begin to see what they see, and it hurts. Like, I was just crying, and I told Sarah, and I said, listen, I said, there's a lot of celebrities. I said, they're depressed. Like, such a spirit of depression came over me. Such a spirit of oppression. I mean, I started thinking about everything that was wrong. And finally, I had to catch myself. I said, hold up. I said, this ain't even my stuff. How many of you guys understand that a lot of the things that you feel and you experience really ain't about you? Sometimes God will allow you, because I understand that I'm an intercessor. And I had to remind myself of who I was. I said, hold up. I said, no, I'm not. I said, every day is precious in the eyesight of God. Every day that God gives us, you never know if this is your last 24 hours to live. If you knew that, you would spend it completely different. And I began to have a conversation with myself. I said, oh no, hold up, boo. I said, this is not what we do. I said, let's redirect this energy. Let's find out what it is. And I immediately went into prayer. And I contacted my prayer partner. I was like, girl, you better pray. I said, because these celebrities, they're going through some stuff, because God was showing me, you know, different people. I mean, he was just showing it to me. And I said, think about Robin Williams. To the world, he was the funniest man in the world. One of the funniest, right? You got Jim Carrey, and we can just keep going. Now we got Kevin Hart, the Richard Pryors, the same, you know, what my dude name? Because I still call him Sanford. Red Fox, you know. But God began to show me these people, how privately, publicly, they appear to have it all going on. Y'all remember the teaching I did on being Mary Jane? Publicly, you know, she had the car and she had the money and she could spend $30,000 on a purse. But when she went by herself, she had some areas that were unfulfilled. Come on. And so God began to give me that burden. And then he said, Carla, he said, you're burnt out. He said, all of that wasn't about you. He said, but you need time. I mean, he said, remember when, and I'm going to just be honest. Like, some people are not going to be honest with you. They're going to tell you they always get up and pray. They always get up and fast. They just always, and that's the problem. They just always do what they're supposed to do. Lies they tell, okay? Because there are times when I would get up and might just get right into, oh, I got to do boss women pray. Oh, I got to do birth for Jesus. And God was like, all of that is good, but that's pouring out. You got to make sure that you get in that place with me so that I can pour in. I'm helping somebody, because some of you as boss women, because I'm a boss and I'm a boss lady, I make boss moves. Yeah, but if you don't get before the Father consistently, somebody say consistently, you're going to begin to pour out of an empty well. So you got to make sure that you get before the Father every single day. Come on. I'm not talking about where you're preparing for Boss Women Pray or we're preparing for Burn for Jesus. I'm talking about God put such a burden on me. Guess what book in the Bible he led me to start reading? And I was like, hold up. Lamentations. Why you got me reading Lamentations? I don't want to read that. Sad, depressing, talking about Jerusalem, you know, all of that. I don't want to read that. He said, nah, because I need you to see, I need you to feel the burden that I feel so that you can release what I have for you to release in the earth. See, we want to go to the good books of the Bible. We want to go to the ones that make us feel good. We want to go to Psalms and David of the Lord, you know, where David, you know, sung a song before the Lord. But what about when he have you going to, you know, going to the ones that ain't so popular? You know, I don't remember the last time I heard a preacher preach out of Lamentations. I don't know the last time I heard that. I don't think I've ever known anybody to preach out of Lamentations. You understand? But I wanted to take a moment, and I read a book last year, or was it this year? Can't remember. Called Overload by one of my favorite authors. Y'all already know. Who's one of my favorite authors? See how well y'all know me. One of my favorite authors, favorite speakers. She is a mentor that really helped me step out of my comfort zone, and I became comfortable, more comfortable in sharing my story. Who is she? Who is she? Tell me. Joyce Meyer. You got it. So this is the book, Overload. Y'all are so amazing. Y'all are so amazing. How to unplug, unwind, and unleash yourself from the pressure of stress. Now, I want to say this. Some of the stress that we experience is self-inflicted because we, you know, for some reason we feel like we got to do so much. Remember, I even told y'all, get away from the to-do list. And, you know, but because, you know, some of us, we have so many people that pull on us and, you know, there's expectation and there's deadlines. Oh, I got to do this and I got to do that. But my mind really was just tired. So some of the signs that you're burnt out is weariness. When you begin to think more about what's wrong than what's right, that's a sign that you're burnt out. When you begin to get frustrated, I noticed a change in my attitude around the house with my daughter and every little thing started getting on my nerves, or, you know, that's a sign of burnout. When you don't really want to get out of the bed, that's a sign of burnout. Or when you tend to overdo it, that could be a sign of burnout too. So I want to encourage you guys to get this book called Overload by Joyce Meyer, How to Unplug, Unwind, and Unleash Yourself from the Pressure of Stress. And let me say this. I read something one day that changed my mindset forever, and I believe it was by Valerie Burton in Happy Women Live Better. She said, what did she say? She said, in the society that we live in, we tend to downplay stay-at-home moms and make those of us that operate in corporate America or as entrepreneurs as if our positioning is a lot better than a stay-at-home mom. And that's not true. So what we do as boss women in the marketplace or from the pulpit to the marketplace equates to that of a mother that decides to stay home and raise her children. Her husband goes to work or he's in the military or he goes out to make the money. Because being a mother, you understand, it's no easy task. And so I want to say that for those of you. And then you got another thing I'm dealing with. My daughter transitioning into a teenager. So I'll be about to choke her every day. So that's another thing. You know, it was like with the things that I'm dealing with as far as, you know, working on my goals and my dreams and all of that. But I had to make sure that I take care of Carla. But at the same time, I'm raising a teenager in my house. You know, my daughter... it's 13, about to be 14 on December the 11th. So a lot of the things that used to work for her no longer work. A lot of the conversations that I used to have with her, I can no longer have. It's like I find myself brainstorming on how to talk to her when she get home from school. Come on. And so that's stressful. You know, and then she has a father that works all the time. He's a great provider. You know, but then there's times where I'm like, listen, you got to pause and have conversations with her because I need her to know, like, you're here, you're her dad, not just you provide when she needs something. You know what I'm saying? And I have to make sure I don't do the same thing. I got to make sure that I pause for my work long enough to actually communicate with her. You understand? And so, and laying on the hands and all of that is good, but sometimes we can over-spiritualize things, you know. I get it. I understand we're going to pray. We're going to lay our hands. But sometimes we need to have conversation. Sometimes we need to just sit down and we need to implement more practical things combined with the spiritual aspect. So, yeah, we're going to pray and we're going to lay hands and we're going to do all of those things. But there are some things that you just simply got to have a conversation Ruby Woo mixed with Flat Out Fabulous. You got to have a conversation. And that's one of the problems right there with the church. While we're losing our young people, we're losing the millennials, because all we say is line them up at the altar, lay oil on them, lay them out, and then they get right back up and like, bro, we is not doing none of that. You know what I'm saying? Because it's going to take a little bit more. It's going to take a little bit more from that. So I want to encourage you guys to get the book. And by no means am I saying prayer does not work. Prayer works, but we don't want to become so over-spiritualized. Imagine if I was like this, you know, when I got up yesterday and I was like, this is an attack of the devil. Devil, I bind you in the name of Jesus. See, some of y'all are binding devils that don't even exist. You're binding devils. You think you're binding them, but what you're really doing is inviting them to come, because they over there chilling, minding their business. They ain't even at your house. They ain't even at your house. And because you don't have a discerning of spirits and you're saying, devil, I bind you in the name of Jesus. And God is like, no, you're just tired. You need sleep. This is called anxiety. This is no attack on the devil. This really is not depression. This really is you're just tired. You need to go to sleep. You need to take a nap. You know, Sarah knows sleep is one of the hardest things for me to do. I'm like, Sarah, I'm supposed to be resting. And she's like, cut your phone off. Turn off social media. And I'm like, I'm trying. Now I want to read a book. Like, I had to make myself not even read a book. Oh, y'all know I love to read. I'm sitting in the place, got a book in my purse. And while I'm waiting for them, I'm like, I'm going to open up, finish reading the Esther Anointing. God was like, no, you're not. Put it down. You mean to tell me that God would tell you to put the book down? Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Because sometimes there's things that God want to say to us, and he just wants us to just chill, relax our mind, let your conscience be free. You know, something. And then I had to learn how to become comfortable sitting in silence. Just sitting in silence. And like when I first, one of the things I'm working on doing, yeah, you got to unplug consistently. I say you got to unplug. Every day you got to detox. It's called Overload, Baby, by Joyce Meyer. You got to detox. And you got to get these things off of your mind, because guess what, y'all? We carry stuff from day to day to day to day to day. And we just carrying it. But when do we ever release it? We carry the burden of our coworkers. We carry the burden of the mothers and the sisters and the deacons and the ministers and the pastor of the church. But when do we release that stuff? Maybe we ain't going to get to this today, Boss Woman Pray. I'll do a video on that. I really feel like this, what I'm talking about is what I'm supposed to talk to you about today. Like overload. So many of y'all are on overload because you're like, I got to show up. I got to be on the scene. I got to this and I got to that. No, it's okay to unplug. I'm still learning that it's okay to unplug. And guess what? I got to do some tweaking, because my sanity is more important than getting on Periscope every day. Mm-mm. So I said, okay, God, 8 o'clock doesn't work for me with this burn for Jesus. He's like, all right, well, then push it back to 6. I was like, okay, cool. Well, I'll do 6 because 6 is better. Because by the time 8 come, really, that's family time. I'm really like, Sarah don't have no kids. So when I'm the one that chose 8 o'clock. Come on. But now I notice, because I experienced burnout, 8 o'clock doesn't work for me. So I said, okay, I'm going to either have to do 5 o'clock or I'm going to have to do 6 o'clock. But that 8 just doesn't work for me. So I had to listen to myself. I had to pay attention to my triggers. Come on. Because again, some of y'all think you're casting out. You think it's depression and oppression and it's all this other stuff. And sometimes because we're tired and we're sleepy, we end up getting in arguments with people that we really love. Simply because you need a nap. You understand? So I want to encourage you, ladies. I really do. I wanted to come on and encourage you to take time for you. I called yesterday Carla Day. I said, this is National Carla Day. But guess what? Not only am I going to take a Carla Day, yesterday, but I have to pencil in a Carla Day every week. I said, for now, if that means my Carla Day has to be Monday for half a day and then the other half I do my vision casting and planning, then that's what I'll do. But I have to take care of me, and you got to take care of you, because guess what? Speaking opportunities, books to write, books to read, none of that stuff is going anywhere. There's always going to be somebody to inspire. There's always going to be somebody to encourage. Listen, the Bible said the poor will always be among you. Come on. And so you got to understand that you can pace yourself and understand this. Hey, Darlene, understand this. There's always going to be somebody to minister to. So even those of you that may be in seminary, or you may be still in the process and you're ready to come out the oven, pace yourself and take your time, because ministry ain't going nowhere. Marketplace ain't going nowhere. But what do? We get caught up watching everybody else and what they're doing. And they're doing this and they're doing that. And I ain't gonna make money if I don't show up. Yeah, you will. Get creative. Systemize your business. Plug stuff in. So you ain't gotta be so busy working, you know, on your business. I mean, working in your business that you're not working on your business. Because there is a difference. And so that concludes what I had to talk about today. I really want to encourage you guys. And I'll do these videos. I'm going to do these videos, put them on YouTube, upload them, and you'll get to see them. But this book is really, really good by Joyce Meyer, Overload, called Overload, okay? Get the book. I read it. It's either was last year or this year. Can't remember. How to Unplug, Unwind, and Unleash Yourself from the Pressure of Stress. So I want you guys to tell me before we get ready to get out of here, what is one thing that, now first of all, did this apply to anybody? If it applied to you, put a one on the screen. If this was exactly what you needed, put a one on the screen. If this helped you, put a one on the screen. If this was an answer to your prayer, I love you too, put a one on the screen. Put a one on the screen if you said this was what I needed. She put a whole lot of ones. Bless you. Now that I see that this is for so many of you guys, right? What is one thing that you're going to begin to do differently? What's one thing you're going to begin to do differently? Self-care, self-love, and all that is so important. You're so welcome. Okay, so detox. So let's be more specific, right? Because the more specific we are, the more prone we are to actually do it. So when you say me time, what does that mean? When you say self-care, be more specific. Does that mean you're going to go get your hair did? You're going to, you know, what you're going to do? So when you, thank you. So when you take a break, that's good. Let's get specific though. When you say, okay, focus more on me. In what area? Be intentional how you use your time for you. That's good, Darlene. Limit social media. That's good. Depending on who you listen to. Find time to sleep. Make time. So don't say find time. Make time. That's right. Schedule Chevy Day. That's what I did. Spend more time with family and your son. That's good. Because here's the deal, y'all. We bust our butts to go and inspire and we want to do this and we want to do that. When at the end of the day, the people that matter the most aren't even present. We make time for everybody else. Think about it, y'all. We make time for, we make time for all these strangers. When the people around you don't even get the full you. Come on. So, and guess what else I did? When I made that spa appointment yesterday, she said, you want us to schedule your next appointment? I said, yes, ma'am, December. The exact same. I said, December the, I think it was the 14th. I believe it was. Because we did a day back because I wanted it to be on a Tuesday. Yesterday was. What's today? Is today Wednesday? Yeah, today's Wednesday because we had to take the trash to the street. So I wanted it to be on a Tuesday. So for now, guess what I'm doing? Today's the 16th, I heard. So for now, guess what I'm doing? I'm going to the spa once a month, which was my original goal, what I originally intended. Once a month, going to the spa. Once a week, at least once a week, playing something fun. Me and one of my girlfriends are getting together today, and we're going to the movies. You know, so remember in the book, Happy Women Live Better, during one of our sister chats, what did we talk about? We talked about the spirit of anticipation, how anticipation actually releases a happy trigger. So I want y'all to go back through some of those videos that I got on YouTube under Carla Cannon. Love you too. And make sure that you, if you've never been to the spa, you should try it. Make sure that you implement that stuff. So often we go from scope to scope and we just get all this information. But let's make sure that we actually implement the information that we're accumulating, okay? So I love you guys so much. I'm going to go ahead and jump on and do these three different videos so that they can be put on YouTube. And you guys go and subscribe to Carla Cannon on YouTube, okay? And you'll get those 3 days. And then we'll come back 16, 17, 18. We'll come back. We'll be on day 19. So tomorrow we'll be on day 19 because I'm going to do the three that we missed, the two that we've missed, and then today. So we'll be on day 16, 17, 18. Tomorrow we'll be on day 19. And today is Wednesday. So I probably will do Burn for Jesus early. I'm not even going to say what time. When you see me come on, that's when I'm on. I just got to do what works for me, y'all. I feel like 8 for me is a little too late. So Even though I know that was the time that we put out there, but I gotta shift some things up a bit. So I'll be up here tomorrow morning at 8, and we're gonna be on day 19 in the book called Boss Women Pray. Okay, so if you guys are interested in coaching or learning more about me, my books and products, and I just got more shipment of books in. So if you don't have my books, shipments went out yesterday. So if you ordered any books or you hadn't gotten them yet, give it about a week and you should have it. And then if you don't have it, just email me. Just email me, okay? So waiting for your shirt, Cassandra. Yes, I'm waiting on my bling to come in. I'm waiting on my bling to come in. I mailed out some shirts yesterday, but I think with where yours was in the order, I don't think yours is out, is in yet. Well, maybe it is. I can't remember. But I did mail out some shirts yesterday. It could be in that batch. If it's not, then you'll get it in the next batch. So I want to encourage you guys, go to CarlaCannon.com, get some products. Yeah, if you want the bling, Women of Standard shirts, you can get a tunic or a t-shirt. Email me, Carla@womenofstandard.org. Okay, so remember, get that book, Overload, by Joyce Meyer. Apply those principles. Thank you. Apply those principles and prevent burnout. And thank you so much. And so I'm on the path to really taking care of myself, like really taking time for me, because it can be stressful. You know, it's so much to do, so many goals, so many ideas, and then I got this innovative mind. But I got to pace myself, put that stuff in a catch-all notebook and keep it moving. So you guys be blessed. I'll be back on later today. I might do Burn for Jesus during the day. I can't even say. I gotta shut down at a certain time and just shut everything down. And that's what's going to work for me. I just have to find a different balance, because what I tried to do was bring into this season the same schedule and the same system that worked last season, and it's just not working. It doesn't work. And so you got to be willing to be flexible. And if something worked for you last season, you know, like Mondays is vision casting day, Fridays is planning, and da-da-da-da-da. Well, clearly that ain't working in this season, so I have to do something else. And then making sure that I use my time wisely, so that I don't work past, you know, a certain time. So y'all are really on this lipstick. What it is I went to the MAC store yesterday. See, that was another. Y'all know I love the MAC store. I went to the MAC store yesterday, and I asked them how do you ombre your lips? And I still didn't get it right. But so they told me to, like, line my lips or whatever, and then put Ruby Woo on the outside, and then put the pink, the Flat Out Fabulous, in the middle, and then rub them together, and then give it, like, a dark look. So I love you guys. I appreciate you rocking out with me. I'm still offering coaching. I'm just going to really sit down and dig into my schedule to, you know, change some things around. I meet with my assistant and we're going to change some things around, because I got to do something different. Because, yeah, I just got to do something different. So, again, to all my stay-at-home moms, look, shout out to you. We salute, because what you do is no different than what we do. Because raising these kids, man, raising children, it's hard work. Like, I'm being honest, y'all. Like, I'm going to be honest. Like, I don't want no more kids. I thought I did. I got a whole faith drawer with little boy stuff. Anybody having a son, let me know. I'll send you some gifts. I don't want no more kids. I'm cool. I think I was designed to have one child and one child only. Now, if I get married and fall in love and all that stuff and something changed, that's different. But as of right now, I think I'm good. Like, I just want to travel the world. You know, take my family to, you know, show them different things that they've never seen before. Take them places they've never been. And my assignment is to get my daughter, you know, through high school, into college if she choose, you know, to, you know, do what it is that she desires to do, and just back her 1,000%. So, yeah, and then within the next, you know, 12 months, this time next year, planning to relocate. So it's a lot of stuff that's on my plate. And so I'm just praying. But yeah, I'm praying for y'all with them kids. That ain't no joke. Being a mother is a big deal. You know, that's a lot of different personalities. It takes skills to be a mother, because you got to know when to talk to them, how to talk to them, when to be their friend, when to be their mama, when to... Oh, it's draining. Praise the Lord. And it literally takes a village. Yeah. So, y'all be blessed. I'm going to go ahead and knock out these videos really quickly. So, y'all get ready for them. Go to Carla Cannon on YouTube. Subscribe. Hit the subscribe button. I want to see my notifications going crazy, because some of y'all aren't subscribed, but I've got a lot of y'all that have. But if you have not subscribed to Carla Cannon on YouTube, go and click on it. And so that way, soon as my, yes, I am, as soon as I upload the video, you'll get a notification and you'll be able to watch it, okay? So remember, there's some keys to preventing burnout. Pay attention to your body. Make sure you spend adequate enough time with God. Don't be afraid to put yourself first. You know, always remember, put the mask on you first before you put it on somebody else. Why is my computer... See, that's why I don't like my daughter. See, that's that stuff. Patience was on my computer yesterday, and I was like, don't touch my computer. Now it's not coming on. All right, y'all. Y'all be blessed. Have a good day.